So in today's video, I just wanted to show you quickly how you can enable hand gestures on your Apple Watch so you can use it without actually having to use another hand to tap on the screen. So a quick example here. I've got mine set up as double gesture, double clench to go to the main menu, double pinch to go back, one clench to open it up, and you can literally navigate. So to enable these hand gestures on your Apple Watch, which by the way, Apple states that it has to be Apple Watch Series 4 or higher, or it could be the SE1 or second generation and the Apple Watch Ultra. So as long as you've got one of them watches and you're on the latest software version, if you're on the latest watchOS version, you shouldn't have a problem. So if you just head to the Apple Watch app, you want to go to accessibility. You scroll down and on the motor you can see there's assistive touch. You just go to there and you can see there's a bunch of different here. So we've got inputs and there's scanning style, appearance, and there's a menu customization. But what we want to do is turn assistive touch on. We want to head to hand gestures, and here if we toggle hand gestures on, we can see there's custom you can customize your gestures just here. So, like I said, I had pinch as going forwards, double pinch going backwards, clench to tap, and double clench to show up. So you can literally map them to whichever one. You can map them to different shortcuts. You can map it to the digital crown to scroll. These are interactions with the motion pointer, which is another setting. Again, to the digital crown. Simple actions. So whichever one, you just play about with them, whatever functionality works. The activation gesture here with the double clench means when you turn the watch, you'll see it lights up with the blue thing and you have to double clench to activate it, and you'll feel vibration and one of your elements on your watch will get circled. So now we can see that it's activated. So I just went to the weather up there. I mean, also you can just get back to your watch face by doing that. If you have to kind of do it quickly with the ring showing up. If you don't, then you can activate it at some point further down the line. So you get notifications coming through. You can action them. It'll come up with an option to allow you to respond or dismiss.
So it all in all,
it is a really good feature for those who
would obviously need it in some disability circumstances, but if you just want to make
things a bit more convenient, if your hands are tied up or if your right hand is not available or whichever hand, other hand, you could always do that. A bunch of other things you can enable on there is a motion pointer. So if I go there and you can see motion pointer here, this basically allows a pointer to be enabled on your screen, and you have various settings within here that you can change to allow different things, the movement tolerance, the activation time, the sensitivity of it. Then you have hot edges, if you point the
pointer in those corners of the screen,
what actions they would do. You have dwell control.
So if I turn that on and shake to start. See the pointer comes up, and if you hold it in a certain place, it can activate things.
You can pause it up here.
Pause motion sensor, you can use this tap to point, which will obviously go into the application. And you can obviously combine it with different things. So if you just want to pause it. all in all, it's quite a handy feature if you wanted to make life a little bit easier. Give it a go, activate it on your watch, see what happens, and if it's something that could be useful to you. Thanks for watching, guys.